From the earliest stages of their childhood, Heathcliff and Catherine shared an inseparable bond. They were the epitome of friendship. As the innocence of childhood fades, their friendship burgeons into a wild and unquenchable passion, which consumes them like a raging fire, destroying everything in its path. Their relationship, to be or not to be, that was the question. Fate decided it was not to be. This series of unfortunate events began with the bite of a dog. On that fateful night, the bite on the heel began a chain reaction that would change Catherine's and Heathcliff's lives forever. This injury placed her in the benevolent arms of the Lintons, who earnestly watched and cared for her. She returned a changed woman. Heathcliff was no longer enough for her. Their dance of friendship was interrupted, and Edgar Linton with society cut in. Heathcliff's and Catherine's relationship would never be the same. His mind was polluted with thoughts of hate and revenge. His vengeance would be fulfilled.
You always treat me like this. At least when we're alone, you treat me decently. When we're with him, you treat me like a child, unqualified for your affection.
Oh, Heathcliff, you're such a baby! He is out of your league. He's a gentleman.
Anger and unkindness filled their hearts, especially Heathcliff's, who allowed her aloof behavior to penetrate deeply into his soul.
I do.
Edgar and Catherine were happily united by the bonds of marriage. Ecstasy abounded, save in one, Heathcliff. Perdition, betrayal, mistrust. All caused bitterness and agony within his tormented heart. Heathcliff departed, revenge on the forefront of his mind.
I can't believe it. My beloved Heathcliff is coming back. Isn't it wonderful, my love?
You say so, dearest.
My friends, it's been too long.
Heathcliff!
Edgar's uneasiness overflowed with the presence of Heathcliff. This uneasiness was not unmerited. Heathcliff, Catherine, and Edgar's sister, Isabella, were becoming close companions, leaving Edgar alone and powerless to fight against the dragon inside of Heathcliff. Over time, Isabella acquired an unhealthy desire for Heathcliff. Heathcliff welcomed these affections with open arms, seeing them as another way to wound his beloved.
You have got to stop toying with Isabella's heart.
It's too late. She's already mine. You know, I only did this to hurt you.
What's going on here?
It's not your affair, sir. Stay out of it.
Edgar, are you gonna let him talk to you like that in your own home?
Come on, man!
I'll be back.
Where'd he go?
Catherine, confining herself to her room, refused to eat for 2 days. Edgar's many entreaties went unheeded.
Isabel, if you continue relationships with that man, our ties will be severed.
Disregarding her brother's warning, Isabella elopes with Heathcliff. Edgar earnestly tended his sick and pregnant wife. During this time, Isabella was suffering from her rash decision. Heathcliff was no longer the knight in shining armor he had pretended to be. Catherine's health was failing. Death was imminent. For Heathcliff, this was unbearable.
You deserve this. You've killed yourself.
Forgive me. I forgave you.
You're responsible for breaking both our hearts. Forgive you for what you've done to me. I love my murderer, but yours, how could I?
I hate everything about you. What do I love you?
Even after Catherine's death, Heathcliff continued to wreak havoc upon her loved ones. He was tormented by her until his death, when they were reunited to be one forever.